Hi there, good Monday evening. I'm Storm Watch 9 meteorologist Matt Hoenig. We are keeping an eye on a messy stretch of weather by midweek following a really nice day of weather for the first day of April. Alert weather Wednesday and Thursday, and this one looks to feature more wintry weather. Several inches of heavy wet snow possible, especially over the interior and particularly up in elevation. There will be significant snowfall totals with this next storm system. Farther south and along the coastline, we'll likely be dealing with some mixing when it comes to sleet and rain, mixing in with the snow at times. That will likely hold down totals in that part of the state. But all of us contending with messy, slow travel conditions. Outages a concern, not just from the heavy wet snow, but also from an increasing wind. And there will be some coastal impacts to talk about. That is a change from the last system we had. A winter storm watch goes into effect Wednesday morning for much of central and northern New Hampshire. All the areas shaded in blue stand the best chance for the most snowfall. And the energy associated with this system is still a long ways away over the center of the country. There actually will be a pretty substantial severe weather outbreak from the Midwest into the Ohio Valley tonight and through tomorrow. We're not, of course, contending with severe storms here in New England, but as a more organized area of low pressure gets going, there will likely be a period of some wintry weather overhead by midweek. A weak weather system diving in out of southern Quebec may tend to bring a couple of sprinkles to far northern parts of New Hampshire. In the next couple of hours, it's really just a few sprinkles, but then it's partly cloudy for the rest of tonight. A light breeze out there. Temperatures running in the 20s and low 30s north, mid and upper 30s in much of central and southern New Hampshire. Tomorrow we may see a few peaks of sun early, but it's largely a mostly cloudy day. As a result, it will not be nearly as warm after some towns got very close to 60 this afternoon. High temperatures will be capped in the upper 40s to around 50 for a lot of us on your Tuesday. Again, early sun fading away to increasing clouds. That next system will likely take some time to get here. I think most of Tuesday night is dry, traveling, hitting the roads, no issues, even into very early Wednesday morning. But likely from mid to late morning onward, a period of some light rain, light mix breaks out for southern New Hampshire, perhaps some wet flakes over interior areas through central and northern New Hampshire. And then through Wednesday afternoon, Wednesday evening, that's really when the weather does start to go downhill. Now, the farther north you are, the better chance you will likely stay all snow in this storm system. You see these pink colors sneaking into the Monadnock region, the lower Merrimack Valley, the coastline. That's where some sleet and rain will likely mix in at times Wednesday night and through Thursday. But remember, this is a long duration storm, so most of Thursday will also feature some periods of snow and wintry mix, and the snow totals, they're just going to keep adding up throughout Thursday and even into Thursday night. This is our latest snowfall forecast that features significant totals for the higher terrain of northern and western New Hampshire. From the White Mountains to the Mount Washington Valley and the Lakes region, a foot to a foot and a half of snow is possible. There may be some areas in the higher summits of the White Mountains that pick up closer to 2 feet of snow out of the storm system. Same is true for areas around Lake Sunapee, bleeding down into northern sections of the Monadnock region, like Antrim and Hillsborough. You could see over a foot of snow there as well. Likely lighter totals in some of the lower elevations in central and northern New Hampshire, but still a half foot to a foot of snow likely there. The big wild card is going to be southern New Hampshire. How long do we hang on to snow? How long does the sleet and rain stick around? Those are still questions we're trying to answer in the weather office this evening, but the sleet and rain likely to have an impact on snow totals for Manchester, Nashua, toward the coastline. Lighter totals there on the order of about 1 to 3 inches. In and around the Queen City, maybe a little bit more than that. Same is true for parts of the upper valley from Claremont down towards, say, Chesterfield and Hinsdale. Likely 3 to 6 inches of snow falling in that part of the state. Sleet, freezing rain also likely to create some slippery travel across western zones. There could be a little glaze of ice, especially if we get a couple hours of freezing rain. And then the wind cranks up Wednesday night into early Thursday. For the coastline, that could mean gusts of 40 to 50 miles per hour. But one area to watch is through the western slopes of the White Mountains, right down through, say, Warren, Wentworth, and into Enfield. Right on the other side of the higher terrain, there could be some gusts 50 to 60 miles per hour, and that could lead to some power outages. Also, when it comes to the coastline, by Thursday morning, a high tide cycle could mean minor to moderate coastal flooding at a place like Hampton Harbor. So very messy weather Wednesday and Thursday. Even Friday will likely feature some lingering rain and snow showers. There could even be an additional coating to an inch of snow for northern parts of the state. It looks like we'll start to dry things out by the weekend. And great news, we're 1 week away from the total solar eclipse. An early look at the forecast then. The weather looks promising with sun building in and a milder stretch of weather with temperatures in the 50s.